Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. In a previous video on expressions, you learnt about the animation channel hierarchy, and this enabled you to drive the animation of one object off another. I called this the control axis technique. In this video, you're going to take this technique one step further and combine multiple animation curves into a single curve that will then drive your primary animation. This is possible through combining multiple expression curves or even combining an expression with a keyframed animation. There are plenty of cases where you would use this. For example, controlling the height of a bouncing ball, controlling the intensity of a camera shake, or perhaps controlling the randomness of an object in a motion graphic. If you'd like to follow along, please click the link in the description below. Alternatively, if you're watching the podcast, then please type the displayed link in your web browser. Now load the batch setup and go into this action node with a 2-up view using Alt 2. In this example, you have a background image, camera, a light, and a text object. If you scrub the sequence, there is no animation on any object in the composite. Now I'd like you to take the Z rotation of this 3D object and animate it using an expression. So shift-click the Z rotation of the 3D text axis and switch to the animation editor. We'll use the sine expression to create the animation. Type sine, open bracket, frame divided by 3, close bracket, multiplied by 20. So the sine curve is generated with a factor of 3, and the maximum angle of rotation is set to 20 degrees. Frame the curve to the animation editor if required. When you press play, you can see how the text is now rocking on its Z-axis, and this is continuous. Now to build onto this example, you'd like the text to start still, and then gradually begin rocking forward and back. It is possible to write this into a single expression, but I think using a controller is much easier and more flexible. Select the 3D Text's axis node and reset it through the contextual menu. Now switch back to the action node bin. You can use any object with animation channels as your controller, but generally, artists tend to have used a dummy axis node to drive animation. This is perfectly adequate for the task. However, it does put an extra moving axis in the scene, which could be distracting as you work. So as an alternative, you'll use a matchbox node. Very importantly, ensure nothing is selected in the action schematic. Next, using either the node bin or the contextual menu, add a matchbox node to the 3D scene. In the file browser, scroll to the bottom of the list and choose a matchbox shader called variables. Now this matchbox shader is pretty much a null object. Visually, it does nothing to the composite. However, looking at its menus, it gives you pages of sliders, icons, and color pots that you can use for anything. So firstly, rename the node to Control. Now let's put the initial expression into the first variable channel. Shift-click the channel to select it, and switch to the animation editor. Click the Expressions button, or press close square bracket to open the Expressions editor. Type sine, open bracket frame divided by 3, close bracket. This creates the sine curve using a factor of 3. But without the additional multiplication of 20, like the initial expression, this sine curve will only move between minus 1 and 1. At this point, you're only considering the shape of the curve and not its intended height or amplitude. So in the next channel, you'll need to create the incline curve to control the height of the sine curve. Select the var2 channel and open the expressions editor. Type frame divided by 5. This will create the curve based on the frame number, and you can control the linear incline through mathematics. so the first two variable channels operate independently. To combine the two channels together, you'll use the third variable channel to do the math. Select var3 and open the expressions editor again. This time, type var01 multiplied by var02. This combines the two expressions into a single curve, and now you'll link this to your 3D text's rotation. Select the var3 channel and click copy. Select the 3D text axis and locate the Z rotation channel in the animation editor. Select it and press the link button. When you play the composite, the text starts off static and starts rocking more and more each frame. So that's how you can combine multiple expressions together and then apply them to the object's animation channel. However, I did mention at the beginning of this video that you can also combine a keyframed curve with an expression. So if you didn't know how to write the second expression, or you wanted to manually adjust it, this is also possible. Select the control node and scroll to the var2 channel. Select the channel and reset it. You won't have to link everything again, as the expressions are still looking at the same channels. Turn on autokey. On the first frame, set the var2 value to 0. Go to frame 50 and set the value to 20. You want this value to remain constant up to frame 100, so go to frame 100 and set a keyframe. If your curve is bezier like mine, change the curve interpolation to linear. Finally, at the end of the composition, you want the rocking motion to stop. So set the value to 0 at the end of the composite. What's really handy to note is that as you're making these keyframes, the curve for var3 is updating dynamically. Straight away, you can play or scrub the composite and then carry on tweaking after the fact. You can even edit the expression in var1. For example, edit the expression to only use the frame number to generate the sine curve. This increases the frequency of the curve and the rocking motion is more volatile. But all of this remains confined within the keyframed curve on var2. So combining multiple curves, whether keyframed or using expressions, is a powerful workflow to have at your disposal, and you can take total control of your animations. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for updates and new videos, and comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thanks for watching.